Hi guys, to another video on Tyron. So I know I don't make these kind of videos often, like on music, you know, I'm normally on that, you know, Roblox games bag, you know what I mean? But I thought of changing up a little bit. I'm really into music, I've done some music videos in the past and everything, so here I am. So this is really about the music that I've been listening to recently and what I grew up with, you know what I mean, so far. And quick disclaimer, I know the camera quality is quite bad. I'll try and get that upgraded on the next time. But yeah, anyway, let's get into the rules for the tier list. So I have it as it has to be in the contemporary alternative genre. I only allowed one album per artist to allow more variation and everything. Also acknowledge like this list is gonna be very subjective and everything. It's gonna be albums on a list with like, how did I make it and this didn't. But it's just a lot of these musics, what I listen to and everything, what really got me in my feelings and everything. And as I said, these are songs and albums that I've listened to throughout my upbringing so far. And if I was to make a list again like this, that's objective, it would look much different. So, you know what I mean? And also, pretty much none of these albums are in particular order. Maybe like the top three, I could say, is I listed it as in order, but that's really it. Yeah. Anyway, let's get into the list. At number 10, I have Awaken My Love by Childish Gambino. This album really showed the public, his fans, his haters, his ability to flex his vocals to be more melodic. You know, it shows more his spiritual self, and he really does deliver a soul-moving alternative R&B album that is consistently interesting and hard-hitting. This is achieved through complex production, which always knows when to climax. My favorite tracks include Me and Your Mama, Have Some Love, Redbone, Terrified, and Stand Tall. At number 9, I have Friends That Break Your Heart. This is the most recent album on the list, not to like spoil, but I did, which can be hard to achieve in my opinion. Cause recently I noticed like R&B has really become stale, and artists are trying to reinvent what was achieved by artists like Bryson, Party, Brent, and it ain't hitting the same, know what I mean? Like, on the other hand, James is consistently able to show off his heavenly vocals while singing on beats which are like completely unique. This can be seen in Frozen, which used these plucked strings and this growing sample, I don't know if that's the best word to use, but on the back while having like massive synths throughout. It's truly a masterpiece, I'm telling you. Favorite tracks include Famous Last Words, Life Is Not The Same, Funeral, Frozen, and Say What You Will. At number 8, I have Trap Soul. This is probably the most evident album on the list, as it really did revolutionize R&B into a more calm soul type genre. Even though track list isn't perfect, you could say it has like duds, but it makes like some of the highest highs of R&B, you know, such as Don't and Exchange. Favorite tracks include Exchange, For However Long, Don't, 502, Come Up, Been That Way. At number 7, I have War and Leisure by Miguel. I think this is Miguel's most cohesive project. With Beat Tribes, even though it was released in December, which was like a bad marketing decision, can't lie. Miguel's voice is sounding as fresh as ever on this record. I think that Miguel's selection of beats is the best, as it contains like more variety of feelings. Favorite tracks include Criminal, Pineapple Skies, Banana Clip, Haram, Told You So. At number 6, I have Collection 1 by St. John. I know some might consider this album as rap, but if I'm going to include Trap Soul, I might as well include this. St. John falls short in many aspects, such as being not very lyrical, substantive, and sometimes being formulaic. However, on this first album, I see John being the most experimental, with some of the best beats and vocals of his career. The dark eeriness of some tracks really bring out this urge to like go out. It's weird, like trap, but it still blends it with R&B as well, just like Trap Soul. Favorite tracks include Lust, Three Below, Roses, Tracy Lords, Some Nights. At number 5, I have Blonde by Frank Ocean. This might be as predictable as Trap Soul for how popular in the culture it has been and become. However, it has deserved every bit of it. Frank's ability to strip back the beat to a single instrument, for example a guitar, and just sing his ass off, it's just impressive to me. My favorite tracks include Ivy, Pink and White, Self Control, Nights, and White Ferrari. And number 4, I have Waking at Dawn by Roy Woods. Many might not know this album, and only know Roy Woods for his collaboration with Drake and the Oval label, but his solo work is left unappreciated, which is evident with his solo album, Waking at Dawn. This bright but saturated sun behind Roy in the album cover perfectly encapsulates the record. The haunting vocals of Sonic Boom, to moody club bangers such as How I Feel, Down Girl, really give this album a defining theme. My favorite tracks include Sonic Boom, How I Feel, Down Girl, Switch, and Got Me. And now in the top 3, I would say these top 3 are ranked. These are really my 3 favorite albums. And at number 3, I have Free Black by Black. I found this album a year ago after hearing the lead single Problems, which goes crazy. But when I went to see it, if the rest of the album was on par with it, bruh, I was shocked, bruh. Honestly, the first 7 songs are some of the greatest music to grace my ears. The haunting, ghostly opening and vocals Black makes sound like a mix of PND and Weeknd, but still unique. I also really liked his second album, Fall Short of producing good hooks consistently. My favorite tracks include Never Know, Problems, Free, Learnia, MTFU. And number 2, I have House of Balloons by Weeknd. The debut mixtape of Weeknd could be considered his strongest. He really began the whole wave of dark soul, R&B music. The songs here are so intoxicating, and as said on the opening song, you want to be high for this. I can't even lie, there are no skips on this album, and all tracks are all amazingly produced, even if some are dragged out, like lo-fi in my opinion. My favorite tracks include What You Need, House of Balloons / Glass Table Girls, The Morning, The Party and The After Party, and Coming Down.
First honorable mention is Control by SZA. I honestly think this is a very good album. I know she's the only female on this list and she's only in an honorable mentions, but as I said, it's a subjective list, and I don't know, no females in the industry really connected me with that. But honestly, this album, I think it's better than SOS. I don't know, I think it's the perfect length and everything. It has really good vocals by her. It's a good, solid listen. Next, I have Fetty Wap by Fetty Wap. This might be a unexpected choice on the list, as most people just think this is maybe Fetty Wap's best album, but just because it has his best singles, like Trap Queen, Again My Way. I can't lie, Even in some like deep cuts, everything just goes hard. There's a lot of deep cuts that just are still very good, like No Days Off. So I think it's quite an underrated album, as in an album that's fully appreciated for every song, other than just for the few singles that got really popular. I still think Sondersun is Brent Faiyaz's best project today. I believe so, because first, I think this is his most personal album to date. I can see like a running theme throughout the track list. This was replicated or tried to be replicated in Wasteland, which I don't think exactly worked. Another reason is this album mostly uses a guitar, which allows him to actually show off his vocals, as it's mostly just one or two instruments, and if there's more, he's still able to sound mostly clear. Obviously, the mixing isn't the best on this. Obviously, I think his latter projects get better with that. But some of his recent projects, he doesn't pick the best beats to sing on, and I think this project does it the best. So, still, I think I'm making a separate video on Sondersun and why I still think it's the best.
Alright, we finally made it to the number one spot. And if you have not guessed already, it's Party Next Door 2. This is honestly my favorite R&B album. And one of my favorites of any genre. Some might think of his first output, Party Next Door, triumphs his sophomore project, but I beg to differ. Don't get me wrong, if I didn't have the rule of one album per artist, both albums would have cracked it. But I believe that his second project improves in really every way. The cohesiveness of each song, the tracks having climaxes and developed to fully reach their potential, his voice is used in more interesting ways, and thirsty. We'll get on to that. Well, yes, the album isn't the most lyrically complex and doesn't really have a message to promote. The second you hear the opener, East Liberty, you get transported into a highway at night driving, bumping this. And this continues for every track on the album. This is not to say every song falls in the background, but it's smooth and intoxicating. A very similar feeling to House of Balloons, which is second on this list. But for why I hold this higher, is maybe Party goes darker and more sexual, which really had me in my feelings for a while. This is most evident on the track Thirsty, which is my favorite. It starts off playing this Missy Elliott sample when suddenly the beat switches to this almost Skrillex beat, but develops more and more until it reaches like this beautiful climax. It's truly a masterpiece, and you have to listen to it.
I wanna kiss you, girl. I wanna kiss you, girl. I wanna love you.
You know, I like this album so much. I might make a separate video on why I love this album so much. But meanwhile, Party has his fourth upcoming album soon. But honestly, what was Brody smoking when he made that cover? Is he actually going to think that someone's going to buy that vinyl? He was not thinking when they made that one. Favorite tracks include East Liberty, Her Way, Belong to the City, Recognize, Options, Thirsty, About It. It's pretty much every single album, a song on the album. Well, anyways, go check it out, see if it's any good, if you like it, and do the same to the others on this list. And that's gonna wrap up this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. One of the videos I put more effort in. But tell me if you agree or disagree with my takes. Share some of your opinions on music, your top 10 R&B albums. I would like to hear that really in the comments. And if you want me to continue these kind of music videos, I will. As I said, I'll make that probably Party Next Door 2 album. Video, Sondersun album. I'm gonna make a reaction to Party's new album. And thanks guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace out.